Okay, assalamu alaikum guys. We're here at Salam Corner. We've got Sheikh Mohammed. How are you, Sheikh? And we've got our dear uncle, what's your name?
Jamaluddin,
uncle, may Allah bless you, inshallah. So we have our uncle here. You was a Qadiyani Ahmadi before?
I was coming.
Okay, so you're going to have a little discussion. We'll hear your story. What led you from Qadiyani to
Islam?
Islam. Please, the floor
yes,
is
yours.
Uncle.
Let me recite the name of Allah and Rasulullah. Salam to Rasulullah.
No problem. Allahumma salli ala Muhammad.
أعوذ بالله السميع العليم من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم هو الله الذي لا إله إلا هو الله الرحمن الرحيم مالك القدوس السلام جل جلاله جل جلاله من وله الصلاة والسلام عليك سيدنا محمد رسول الله الصلاة والسلام عليك سيدنا محمد حبيب الله الصلاة والسلام عليك سيدنا محمد خاتم النبيين الصلاة والسلام عليك سيدنا محمد رحمة للعالمين صلى الله عليه وآله وبارك وسلم.
Brother, let me, uncle, let me just tell you something, yeah, because people, they watch this, and I was quiet, I didn't want to interrupt you because we need to follow the Quran and the Sunnah.
Yeah.
And you mentioned you wanted to praise Allah in the beginning of the speech, and the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he told us in a hadith, any speech, it didn't start by Alhamdulillah, to say Alhamdulillah, praise be Allah, then it is no blessed, there is no blessing in it. So it was best for us to start to say Alhamdulillah, and to say, Wassalatu wasalam ala Rasulullah, no problem. And but I thought you're going to recite the verse of the Quran, هُوَ اللَّهُ الَّذِي لَا إِلَهَ إِلَهُ عَالِمُ الْغَيْبِ وَشَهُوَ الرَّحْمَنُ الرَّحِيمُ. That's the accurate recitation of the verse. But anyway, no problem to mention Allah's names, but it's best to follow the Sunnah. The Sunnah of the Prophet of Allah, because all of us want to follow his Sunnah, yes?
Yes.
So his Sunnah, when he starts in his khutbah, he will say, إِنَّ الْحَمْدَ
لِلَّهِ
نَحْمَدُهُ وَنَسْتَعِينُهُ وَنَسْتَهْدِيهِ. So the hadith, the khutbah al-haja, and as we're sending salutation on the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam to get the blessing of sending salutation on the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, no problem. Yeah? But in terms of saying the khutbah or saying speech or saying even sending salutation on the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, it shouldn't be in a melody way. And it should be just normal. That's, otherwise, the Quran has the only melody way. This is the sunnah. Just wanted to say, and please accept this from me.
Yeah.
Now we want to talk about your journey from Qadiyani to Islam.
Yeah.
And this is for the audience to know that Qadiyani is a different faith. Qadiyani is a faith which is different than Islam. They call themselves Muslim, but they have a certain concept which takes them out of the fold of Islam according to the scholars of Islam.
Yeah.
So that's why the Qadiyani, they are different faith because they believe in other Prophet and other Messenger after the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam.
Yeah.
Now we wanted to hear your story about your journey from Qadiyanism to Islam. Yes, uncle.
Actually, I born Ahmadi. My name is Jamaluddin, and my father was a missionary of Ahmadiyya.
Yes.
And about 80 years ago, because
yes,
I born orphan, because he died before I born, you know.
Yes.
So I brought up with the Qadiyaniyat or Ahmadiyat, they call it.
Yes.
And they, then, but as you, when you born any religion, you actually automatically you follow that.
Yes.
So I was doing all that kind of thing years and years and years. So once, you know, I was in they have a congregation, the big one, every year.
Yes.
So I was there, and one of my cousins, and he was saying in his speech that this is Khalafa of their Khalafa, is a continuation of a Khalafa of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam.
Sallallahu alayhi wa sallam.
So when I heard that ring the bell to me. I said, I asked people, I never read that because I'm with them for years and years. Never read it. maybe I didn't read their books either.
Yes.
Then after that, I start searching and start talking to them. When yes. I start talking to them, they say, Jamal, forget about it. This has nothing to do with you. You know, leave it. Because I knew only their books. I didn't know the Quran. I know the Quran, but the tafsir is there.
Yes.
The translation is there.
Yes.
So I know only that one. But I didn't know the tafsir Ibn Kathir. I didn't know the tafsir Ibn Abbas. I didn't know other tafsirs, you know.
Mashallah.
So I read all this myself. Myself and other books too, you know.
Yes.
Then what I realized, I said, no, this is not right religion. Then once, you know, what happened, I was in their city.
Yes.
And this guide said to me on the road, yes. Oh, the people who don't believe Mirza Ghulam Ahmad Qadiyani, they are a Muslim. And I said, no, can't be that. I never heard of that. So I went to one of my cousin, you know, say that cousin. I asked him, you know, he was also a missionary of their Jamaat.
Yes.
And I asked him, this is what he said, oh, no, Jamal, forget about it. It's not like that. I forgotten about it for a while. Then, you know, keep coming back to those things, you know, start reading books. And then I found their books where this guy claimed to be above Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, na'udhu billah. Yeah. And when I read that, I said, no, it can't be. I can't. It cannot be. Then I read their books. I tried to find out the person who claimed to be a prophet. Then I read about him, you know. I found out he was an imposter because he was put it there because Jews and Christians from years and years, they want to destroy Islam, but they couldn't do it. The reason was when they came to a person, Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, all the Muslims will stick together. Doesn't matter what difference we have, you know, in Hadith and Quran, so
yes.
many things, you know.
Yes.
But and they say we have to bring somebody like him. So they brought him in India. This is only India. At that time, who was ruling?
Varaj.
Yeah. And they brought 14 a companion to him, you know, who was really knowledgeable. Who can do tafsir of Quran or understand Hadith wrong way, not the right way. You see?
Yes.
And they start talking that. And in India, actually, we have this Sufism, Pirism, and some people think he's a Pir. He's a Sufi. So people come to him, you know, talk
yeah.
to him. Yeah, people come to me. Here come to me. Look
yeah.
at that, me.
Yeah.
Me look so weak. Me look something like, people call
yeah,
me.
People, they think you're Sufi. Yeah,
no,
that's
people
right.
call me prophet. Yeah, literally, Jesus, Jews. I've got so many names for people here, you know. Then I realized, I said, no, this now. So I keep, you know, digging out. And then I realized it's completely fake religion. And then one, 2009, I was in their mosque, you know, Masjid
in
Darar.
In their temple.
Yeah, in the Masjid Darar, I call it.
Darar, Masjid Darar.
And there, you know, they say, you know, they say, they were security name, they take my things, everything out. They say, we want to check you. I said, why check you? I said, everybody knows me. How with these people from years? And I didn't know you, why? And I get upset. So I go and sit down on the side. Normally, I used to sit with this guy, Masroor,
yeah.
to understand him, what he is. It's to understand him.
Yeah.
From last 6 years, I did.
Yes.
6 years, every Friday, sit in front of him and try to understand what he was talking about.
Yes.
That day, I was sitting on the side. And when I was sitting on the side, I saw a few people came around me. And I thought, there is something not right. I have 6 and 7 cents. I said,
yes.
there's something not right. And that day, I looked at the people. Because normally, I look at that guy, I never look back. And that day, I was looking at people. When I look at the people, they seem to me, really, they didn't sitting there by their own on their will. They've been made to sit there. And you know, the word came to my mind, they are shackled. And then the word came to my mind, trap. I saw a film, Trap. I knew that. So, you know.
So they set you up. They set you up.
Yeah. And I left from there and came to my car. And my wife was sitting there. I said, I'm not coming back here next time. And next I never go there. 13 years ago, I never go there. I met why my sister went to see her, but she didn't. Because all my family, me and my wife, they left us. They don't accept us.
Even if the whole people left you, if Allah is with you, you don't care about no one. Yeah.
So that was the turning point, which is very wonderful. And when I read Tafsir Ibn Kathir,
Mashallah,
Abdullah, and other books, you know, about 60, 70 books, you could say,
Mashallah.
Then, mashallah, I know my Islam is what the Islam of Sahaba Rizwanullah Alayhim Rasulullah Physically, I'm here, but mentally, I'm with them.
Alhamdulillah.
And that's what I want. And that's what I want.
You wanted to follow them. I will remind you, listen to you. I will tell you something.
Okay. Uncle,
Jalaluddin, you know
Jalaluddin?
Jamaluddin. You know Bilal, Hadrat Bilal, radiallahu
anhu. Oh, love it.
Look what he was saying.
Oh, yes.
When he was dying, on his bed,
Oh, yeah.
His wife was crying.
Oh, yeah.
She said to him, oh, I'm going to lose you. And then she said, no. غَدًا أَلْقَى الْأَحِبَّةِ مُحَمَّدًا وَصَحْبَةً He said, tomorrow, I'm going to meet my beloved ones, Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and his companion.
That's right.
So that's why my brother and all brothers and sisters in Islam, the true Islam is following Quran and Sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and the understanding of the companions, the Sahaba, those are the best generations, the best generation ever from the whole people. There is no better companions to any prophets and messengers of Allah better than the Sahaba of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Because those are the one who brought Islam to India. Those are the one who brought Islam to Africa. Those are the one who went to Azerbaijan. Can you imagine Abdullah ibn Abbas? He went to Azerbaijan to spread Islam.
That's right.
So they went to all the continent, radiyallahu anhum, to call to Islam.
Yeah.
This is how the Sahaba of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam. And they are the best one who followed the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam. Like for example, a few days ago, people they celebrate Milad al-Nabi. You know, people they say Milad al-Nabi. Yeah. We love the Messenger of Allah.
Love it.
We love him more than ourselves, more than our fathers, more than our mothers.
Yeah.
But yet, because we love him, we follow him. We follow exactly what he said. If he told us to celebrate, we celebrate. If he told us nothing, we do nothing. So he, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said he was fasting every Monday. When he was asked, why do you fast Monday, the Messenger of Allah? He said, this day, I was born in this day. And on this day, Allah revealed to me. And on this day, the day of Monday, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, as well migrated from Mecca to Medina. So it's a blessed day, Monday. So that's why the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, used to fast Monday. So if we wanted to celebrate the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, if we wanted to express our love to him, is to fast Mondays like him alayhi salatu wa sallam. Yeah? So many people, they bring these things which is to Islam to the extent you see like this Mirza Ghulam start claiming to be a prophet. Because Islam, when Allah says in the Quran, الْيَوْمَ أَكْمَلْتُ لَكُمْ دِينَكُمْ وَأَتْمَمْتُ عَلَيْكُمْ نِعْمَتِي وَرَضِيتُ لَكُمْ الْإِسْلَامِ دِينَ Today I have completed your faith. If it's complete, why Allah need to send another one? If Islam is complete, why Allah need to send someone else to teach what? Islam is already complete. There is nothing to add. When Allah is saying, Allah who always say the truth. He told us in the Quran, today is your religion is complete. Complete, finished, it's complete. There is nothing to add. وَأَتْمَمْتُ عَلَيْكُمْ نَعْمَةً I have fulfilled my favors upon you. And I'm pleased that Islam is your faith. Allah made it clearly
that's
in
right.
the Quran.
That's right.
So that's why when someone say, no, we need to do something else or to add something else, as if he's accusing Allah, as if, or, and Rasulullah, he's saying Allah didn't complete. وَالْعِيَاذُ بِاللَّهِ أَعُوذُ بِاللَّهِ Or to say the Messenger of Allah didn't convey the message. وَالْعِيَاذُ بِاللَّهِ
This is what he said.
Yeah.
Not complete
yeah,
the message.
Yeah. If someone say, this is what they say.
Yeah.
If this Mirza Ghulam or those ones who claim to be prophets, as if they say, if we say Islam is complete, why Allah need to send someone else? That means it's not complete. There's something else to be extra. Or they say, no, we don't add Quran. We add Sunnah. That means the Prophet ﷺ didn't convey a whole message. They add something hidden.
Yeah.
So all of this contradicts Islam.
That's
so that's why anyone who calls to this path, that's why they're not Muslims.
Yeah.
You call yourself anything, but don't call yourself as a Muslim. So that's why, may Allah protect you, my uncle. May Allah keep you firm in Quran and the Sunnah of the Prophet.
Yes.
And as will I advise my brothers and sisters, don't judge the book from the cover. Because when people they see you, they think you're Sufi or whatever. But you are.
No.
You are trying to follow.
I'm a good Muslim.
Inshallah.
That attracts people too.
Good.
So I give my message to them too, you know.
You, we, yeah, yeah,
say prayer. I do that.
Alhamdulillah. Ask, make dua for the Muslims. Alhamdulillah.
This cult, you know.
It's cult.
Actually, they are straying the Muslim from the Deen Islam. That's what is going on. The reason I came here today, because letting the people know, because this is a fake religion. It is nothing there, nothing there. Even they say pray, even they read Quran, even they do good things, they may be rewarded here, but not there.
Not there.
Not there.
Good.
The main thing is you live for that.
For
if
Allah.
If you, the Most High. Yeah. If you make happy Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, then you've done it.
Yes.
But I'm not worried about the people not happy with me. So bloody what? I am okay.
Alhamdulillah.
I'm happy.
What's your message to the Qadianis? What's your message to them?
I told them many, many times, this is a fake religion. This is nothing to do with Islam. If somebody call himself a Nabi, and he's not Nabi, so, and you are standing with him, he'll be end up in a hell anyway. So you'll be end up in a hell. So the only thing I would say, you study Islam yourself, not their book. That's
exactly,
not Islam.
Exactly.
You read Tafsir ibn Kasir, Tafsir ibn Abbas, and
yes,
other books, you know, which
that's
explain
true.
You everything about Islam. And you believe yourself, because you are answerable yourself, not Mirza Ghulam Qadiani, not Mia Masroor, not your parent, not any your grandparent, nobody answerable. You yourself. And if you stick with them, they are going. If they accept Islam, they may go. They'll be saved from the hell.
Yes.
But if they don't,
no one can save them.
So
and that's why.
The only thing is, you save yourself from hell first.
Yes.
Then the other thing comes here.
Then everything comes. Wallahi, to save ourselves from the hell. You know, Allah says in the Quran,
yes,
فَمَنْ زُحْزِحَ عَنِ النَّارِ وَأُدْخِلَ الْجَنَّةَ فَقَدْ فَازَ. Whoever زُحْزِح means just drifted away from the hell, just barely entered Jannah, he's going to gain success.
Yes.
So just only to drift away from the hell to enter Jannah, alhamdulillah. And as someone said, one pious man said to me, I said to him, he was uncle, I said to him, we have in Jordan and the Middle East, we say for elderly people, we say Sheikh. Sheikh means someone old.
Old man.
Yeah, old man. We say Sheikh. And then he said to me, I'm no Sheikh. He said, I will be Sheikh. If I put my right foot in Jannah, then I am the Sheikh. The one who put his hand, his foot in Jannah, he is the one who is the successful one.
Actually, the word Sheikh here, when I read in the Quran, this is a 3 times.
Yeah.
When you grow old, Sheikh, when you know, Hazrat Musa alayhi salam,
Wabana Sheikhun Kabir, yeah, is old man, yeah.
So I am old man, I'm not that Sheikh.
You are our uncle,
yes,
firstly, and we love the things that came from your words, that came from your mouth, firstly, that Allah has guided you to Islam. That we admire them. May Allah protect
Amen.
You and preserve
Amen.
You.
Amen.
May Allah increase in all khair.
Amen.
And as well, we love as well that you follow.
This is my wife.
MashaAllah.
Yeah. He came with me. Otherwise, I would be in trouble.
Alhamdulillah. May Allah bless both of you. May Allah increase in all khair. Alhamdulillah, Allah brought you to Islam.
Yeah,
Allah saved you.
Yeah,
and there is someone who accepted Islam. One he was followers of the Rafidh, the Shia, the extreme Shias. And he said to me, when I asked him, I said, what did you gain by becoming a Muslim, to become like following Islam? He said, I gained Allah. He said, this man, alhamdulillah, you have Allah blessed with your wife. But this man, he lost his wife, his parents, everyone left him. He said, I gain Allah, even if I lose the whole world.
That's right.
And alhamdulillah, Allah brought you to Islam, you got Allah with you. And Allah brought your wife as well with you, alhamdulillah. That's something which is, we should always praising Allah for this.
MashaAllah.
And
on judgment day, you be all my witness. Don't you worry about that. Will you be my witness that this man is a Muslim?
Alhamdulillah, you are a Muslim, inshallah ta'ala, as long as we believe, as I said to you, the meaning of Islam.
I want to live Muslim,
the shahada,
die Muslim.
And to die as Muslims, and to believe in Islam. And even people who say they're Nabi, Allah says in the Quran about the Prophet, وَخَاتَمَ النَّبِيِّينَ وَخَاتَمَ in some narration of the Quran, وَخَاتِمِ النَّبِيِّينَ the last, the sealed of the prophets. I mean, he is the last, no prophet after him. And there is no messenger after him, alayhi salatu wasalam. No prophet and messenger after him. He is the last one. And his religion is complete.
That's right.
Complete, nothing to add. There is nothing to add. Why Allah, subhanAllah, that's the question for the Qadianis. Ask yourself, if Allah says in the Quran, which you believe in the Quran, Allah says, أَكْمَلْتُ لَكُمْ today your religion is complete. If it's complete, why Allah need to send someone to do more, to do extra? If it's extra, that means not complete. Why Allah sent another prophet if it were to teach you something? Already Allah sent Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, which is authentic sunnah. So everything is complete. Yeah. May Allah reward you, my uncle, and bless you. And I'm honored, you know, speaking to you.
I'm honored. Actually, I saw you. That's why I'm here.
Jazakallah
khair. My God, and I, this is what I want to send message, you know.
Jazakallah
khair. To Qadiani, to Ahmadis, and everybody.
Alhamdulillah. And may Allah guide them to Islam. May Allah guide them to Islam. May Allah guide. All right, auntie.
Yeah. Yeah. Well, we will see it. We find it.
Yeah. Inshallah, you will see. You will see it.
Which program?
We'll see it, inshallah, on all channels, on Speakers Corner channel. You'll see them, inshallah.
Oh yeah, inshallah.
You'll see them, inshallah. All right. Jazakallah khairan. All right.
Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi
wa barakatuh. Rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Assalamu alaikum wa barakatuh.
How are you doing?
Jazakumullah khairu. Okay, Jazakumullah khair, all my brothers and sisters. May Allah Azza wa Jalla bless you all. And alhamdulillah, wallahi, I'm happy, alhamdulillah, to see many of the Qadiani who comes to Islam. And I'm happy to see someone as old as this uncle.
Can you say that again, Sheikh?
I'm happy to see some subhanAllah Qadianis who come to Islam, especially an old elderly man like the uncle.
Sheikh,
alhamdulillah.
I'm not elderly.
Not you, the uncle. Alhamdulillah that Allah brought him to Islam. May Allah bless him. And subhanAllah, and he was saying, I follow Quran and Sunnah. Yani, I love them. Yeah. And he said, people, they see me, they think I'm Sufi. He said, I'm not.
Actually, yeah.
I thought like this. But subhanAllah, that we shouldn't judge the book by the cover. Alhamdulillah, yeah. At least Allah, alhamdulillah, brought him from long journey. Can you imagine someone lived all his life in Qadianism, and then towards the end of his life, Allah bless him with Islam. Allah, that's a great ni'mah. May Allah protect him, and may Allah keep us all firm upon the Quran and the Sunnah of the Prophet.
So when you say he was blessed with Islam, that means that Qadiani and Ahmadiyya
They're not Muslim. Call themselves anything, but not Islam, not Muslims. Okay. That's why we have to understand. If someone disbelieve in one ayah in the Quran, disbelieve in the whole Quran. That's how it is. And he was confirming today, he was saying that they believe, if they don't, anyone who doesn't believe in Mirza Ghulam Ahmad, that they're not Muslims. They don't believe that we're Muslims.
Yeah,
look at this, subhanAllah. Wallah al-musta'an. Yeah. Anyway, Jazakumullah khair all. May Allah bless you all and increase you all. And may Allah increase us all in knowledge and iman.
Did you get the mic from him?